What's up? It's Wednesday. Here I am again, another week, and so excited to be here every single week with you guys because mindset is everything. We see that, but it really, truly is. So I hope you're having a good week. Thank you for pressing play and watching this week's episode with a beautiful guest from the Philadelphia area. Just so well, like you are like well-rounded everything. Amazing.
I try to be.
I mean, and we actually just met for the first time today.
Today.
But what, you are a powerhouse. Like you just like,
thank you.
Your mind, like your mindset and like your energy and everything. So I'm so grateful that like we could come together and that you are able to share with everybody.
Well, I'm happy you reached out.
Yeah.
And I was like ducking you for a little bit, but not on purpose.
No, it's okay. I was like, you know, it's just one of those things that it's a very empowering moment.
Yes.
And like to know the deep two-word story for you and what it is, like that's huge. Like a lot of people, so can you introduce yourself?
First.
I'm like rambling.
We're
like,
already in it now.
This is like the fourth one we've done now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So first and foremost, my name is Sabir Peel. I run the men's style site, mensstylepro.com. Mm-hmm. I'm a brand consultant and I'm also a designer. I design men's clothing, footwear, pretty much anything in that space. And I do some TV here and there. So I'm a busybody.
Yes,
but
he is.
I like to work.
I love it. Yeah, and you came in and I was like, I knew, like I was so excited to see
what
you were gonna wear.
Severe.
I was so excited. Cause I was like, you have the best style.
Well, thank
Hence,
you.
Men's Style Pro.
You know what, and it's funny for like the whole style thing for me, it's very simple. Mm-hmm. I just like think of colors and patterns and I just put them together. They work, they don't, it was my choice.
So when did you start getting into that? I'm curious.
Since I was a kid. Mm-hmm. Really have been since I was a kid. My my grandmother worked as a seamstress and she worked in a dry cleaner for 35 years. My brother and my uncle were like super dope, super fly. And I just picked up those things. Mm-hmm. But I'm also, besides being creative and very business focused. Mm-hmm. So when I went to college, my background is actually organizational psychology and business management. I just had a knack for style and design.
Wow. Yeah. See, this is what I'm talking about. I met him and I was like, what? And then not only were we set up for this meeting, but you just recently launched, what is it, Mental Health Mondays,
yeah.
Mental Health Mondays, which that is, I'm so excited that you're doing that.
You know
so,
what?
I'm so glad.
I'm happy to be doing it, and I think it was cathartic for me because I was going through so much with my own personal struggles, and I was really open with it on social media, but I think I was coming from it from not even like a rambling perspective, but I was giving so much of my story, and it wasn't really like concise. So I wanted to put some of that together and then give advice, but not like from the medical side. I'm not a doctor, but I have a PhD in myself. So it's like I wanted people to...
So true.
To just see that those touch points are relevant to a lot of people and there's ways to kind of help yourself.
It's so, so, so important though.
Yeah.
I mean, and with that being said, I don't know your two-word story, so I love
my
this.
Two-word
Sometimes
story.
I know, and so, but Sabir, take it away.
So since you asked me so long ago and I told you, I took about a week to really think about my two-word story. And for me, I wanted to see something that really related to my life every day. So my two-word story is, create love.
Ooh.
And what I mean, so what I meant by create love was
like, we need to like press play on a song and be like, what's up?
So like, I'm a creator. I create clothing, editorial content, all that. But also for create love, I want to create experience and places and safe spaces for people.
Absolutely.
And moments for people to share things.
Oh my gosh, it's so good.
And it could be
so
from
powerful.
It could be from super mundane or to create like a really really big moment for themselves. And I think for love, I like to create things that I love. And I look to share love with so many people. Because I think what people don't understand is that love is one of the big motivating factors. And I feel like there's not enough in it, or not enough love out there for people.
There's definitely not. And we lose love. And it's a four-letter word.
Yeah.
It's so powerful, but it's like glazed over, right?
Oh,
like people don't really think about the love. And so that word create is so strong before the love.
And sometimes you really have to think about creating it because you get lost in life.
Yes. And week to week. Like this is like
day to day.
Day to day. Absolutely.
I'm sure.
I honestly will message you, because I guarantee by like 6 o'clock tonight, I'm gonna be like, I needed to create love. Sabir, your two-word story like fueled me, and I needed to find love in a moment. I needed to create love.
And that's what it is. Sometimes it's just about creating love in the moment. Mm-hmm. Because like, if you get bogged down and you're trying to like do work or have moments with your people and you're so broken for some reason, the idea of creating love for the people first will pick you back up. Mm-hmm. And then you start creating love for yourself.
It's from within.
Yeah.
Then your light shining. And then your light, and then the light you have is shining into other people. It's like, literally, I see light like shining everywhere around, you know?
Yeah.
It's so important. Was it, so that being your mantra, was it something you've used recently? Like, is there an example you felt like create love? You were like, I need to call upon these two words.
So you know what? We spoke about mental health a little bit, and I get into those like really dark spaces. Mm-hmm. And for me, I had to figure out like, what are the things that I love immediately that will just pick me up a little bit. Mm-hmm. So like, so I'm a father, I have a wife, and sometimes I pull away from them and I realize like, I need to create those moments with them, just if it's small. Mm-hmm. So for me, it was just making a meal. Mm-hmm. I literally went home and I made a meal.
I love this.
And I usually don't get to be home all the time because I work nonstop.
Right.
Because I work for myself.
Right.
And just going home and making that meal and reconnecting with that part of my life helped me create that love moment.
I can't even. The mic has been dropped like 1,000 times. Hey, mic drop.
You brought me here to do this.
I love this. This is so good. And I can't thank you enough for sharing and being open with everybody, you know?
Thank you for having me.
Of course. Yeah. Of course. And like, go ahead.
It's big. Like creating love means more than like an actual tangible thing. It's often just an experience or a mindset. Mm-hmm. And you hear the term mindset thrown around a lot.
A lot.
But creating love for me is the base of creating my day, creating the memories that I have, or just creating a step out of bed.
Right. No, it's true. And I feel like what's lovely about, and what I found for myself is I have this two-word story.
Right.
And I might not be thinking about it, you know, for 3 days, but then I'm struggling in something. I'm like, wait, you literally, it's a way to stop and be intentional within yourself. And I'm like, wait, Alia, big moves, or, you know, I have a lot of two-word stories. I post a lot of two-word stories, but you know, it's so good that you can be intentional with create love.
Yes.
And you are creating love within yourself, which is, that's the key.
Yeah.
And then from there, you're exploding it. It's just like the universe is welcoming it and feeling it. And everything kind of just flows. You're in flow from there.
You put the energy out there.
You're in flow.
The energy's put out there.
Yeah.
Because it only starts with you first. You can't create love in someone else without feeling anything.
No, true. It's so true. I feel like you need to have it on a shirt. I was wearing,
I know.
Wildly enough, yesterday I was wearing Just Love.
Oh.
Okay, because that's a two-word story for my winter season.
Okay.
Just Love, for a lot of reasons, not going into it. But we need to have create
love. I have
love.
A sweater that has a heart right here.
Okay.
And I feel like when I wear it, I give that vibe off.
I love it. Sabir's amazing. How can everyone follow you?
Follow me at Men's Style Pro, and I'm mensstylepro.com. I'm consistent everywhere.
Oh my gosh, and you're fabulous. So it's so good to meet you. Thank you for being here.
Yes.
Yes, thank you. And definitely thank you guys for watching. If you would like to be on the show, please reach out to us. We would love to have you. Thank you. You are. I feel the same way. It's like so much good energy here. We're creating love. And if you guys want to grab a hold of these two words and use them through your week, by all means, message Sabir and say, I really was inspired
by
your story. So thank you guys. Have a good week. Bye.